CapCut is one of the most exciting video editors out there. Simple enough for beginners and yet powerful enough for professionals. So let's get started right away.
First, go to the website capcut.com. There you have the option to click on download. Once you have done that, the system will recognize which operating system you have. Here, for me, it's the Mac version. I automatically get the installation file for the Mac. If you have a Windows computer, you will also get the Windows installation. When you start CapCut, you will see a menu like this. I will now explain how the whole thing works. It's relatively simple. We now have the display of the individual projects here. That means if I click on it now, I can go into the project and continue working there accordingly.
It's the same when I click on Create Project here, a new project is created.
Then there are a few other things here on the left. There are some storage functions in the cloud. I have now created a few directories in the cloud where individual projects are stored.
And we now have the possibility to use a few services, for example, AutoCAD or the screen recorder. These are options, for instance, with the screen recorder, you can record your screen with sound, which you can then use in your videos.
Now you can see some information at the top left. I am a pro customer. I pay for it monthly, and now there's the option first to say we create a new project. So we click on Create Project.
When we have created a new project, it looks like this. We get a display, and what it all means is quite simple. Up here, we first have the option to name what the project is called. I click on it and say, no name.
Then we have the option to import data here. We click on that, or I drag a few data files over from the finder that I have, meaning sources, videos that I created. I have a few videos here. I was in Venice on my last vacation, and I drag these three small clips in here now.
And you can see them up here too. You can play them nicely, like here, or the second video. You can then basically see a preview. And the nice thing is you can already narrow down a bit what you want to use.
That means I'm now dragging the clips into the timeline. I'll start with the first one.
Then I will also show the second, and at the same time, the third.
And down here in the timeline, we have the option to move it left and right with the mouse. And if we now say we want to cut something, that's possible too. We click on it and drag it with the mouse to where we want it.
Let's say here, the beginning is already great. Then we go to the next clip and move something there as well. Well, I like that. Now we go a bit further to the right and there too. Yes, as I said, here below is the timeline. That's quite simply explained now.
And now you have many, many options. In short form, you have a menu with various options up here. On the right, you can see how the corresponding setting is now for this video. You can change and modify them. I'll take a look at that.
You have various options. You can adjust the frame rate. You can adjust the resolution. You can change the name. You can also define a few presets here. We'll leave it as it is and go back to the top left and say the whole thing is quite simple. I've added something here. It looks quite nice because if I let it run now, it's a hard cut. I don't like that. So up here, there's the option to say I would like to have it transitioned.
And that's exactly where we are. We go here and select transitions and say, I would like something, yes, to be blended. Let's take the first one here. We click it down, drag it down here where we want it. And how does it look? I don't know if we'll allow it. It gets pulled in. So you also have a few other options here. I don't like that. So I cover it, remove it with the delete key and pull something else in. Let's take this one. I like it. Pull it down here. Say yes. Grab it again here. Take a look at it.
Yes, also quite nice. We'll just leave it like that. But what I just noticed
what I have noticed is that the sound
Ottoman, it's very loud for me. So if you go into the clip down here, you can see there's a small line. That's the audio volume. We go and lower it a bit. Lowering it is very simple. We click on it and drag it down with the mouse. Here too.
You can later adjust centrally so that your volume is the same everywhere, but I don't like that. It's super loud. So it still needs to run. You can hear it. It's much quieter.
Yes. So regardless of the channel here, the grande, this is an effect we've added now, a transition to be precise. We have many other great things up here. We can say we actually want to add an effect here. That means I have a video here that I don't quite like. I want to add an effect. Then we take something like this, for example.
This now creates a kind of blow effect. Well, that's just an example. I'll remove it again. But there are many other great things. So if you scroll down here, you can also see what it is when you hover over it with the mouse. That means you also get a small preview.
Not right now. You also have the option on the left to choose a theme and then simply drag it down. I'll do it again. Let's take this one here, an effect, and drag it down here. And now it looks like this. We also have the option here to see. We drag it to the left with the mouse and to the right and can then define it. When does an image happen? So now, for example, I don't know what you can do with it. Now it starts. Be careful. I don't like it. I'll take it away again. I actually want something completely different. There's also the option here to say I want to add a sticker, like small mini pictures. Let's take this one. I like it. I'll drag it down. And you can see it here. You can also move it here when you go into the image. Now, I have moved the image. Of course, you first have to click on the sticker, and now I can move it too.
So, I'll leave it like that. It's okay too. Then we click it and see. Great. So we'll leave it as it is. I like that. Yes, then there are many, many other great things we can use here. In the end, it's like this. You can apply filters. That means the background. Let's take this one here. I like it. Let's see it on top here. How does that look? Here too, you can define when it is. Now here, you see it's a bit more robust.
It's gone again. That looks much better. Bam, straight. We can bring in a bit of summer vibes here. Tell ourselves to make it a bit longer. There too, bam. No, let's leave it as it is, so we'll take it away again.
Yes, if you're done now, and you say, yeah, awesome, I want to release it as it is, or upload it, or whatever. As I said, there are many, many other great effects. Watch my videos. I have many great videos where you can check out the individual effects. It's very simple. You go up here to the top right to export. Let's get it started.
Tap, you have the option to set the video quality you want. Leave it as it is in 4K. I want it with the codec like this, and it will be saved here in the directory. I'll say that on export.
And now it takes a little moment. Down here you can see it, 33-40%. I have a MacBook here, and it takes a little moment until it has rendered it. And as soon as it's done, the MP4 file is there, and you can use it, upload it normally wherever you want, whether it's on Facebook, YouTube, or wherever. You can publish it indirectly.
Yes, and how it looks, I've prepared a little video here, what we just exported. You can see how I was genetically on vacation, everything is great, and now I have to show you our smiley. It's super.
Exactly. And now the overlay should come in.
And that was a short video, relatively brief and simple, on how to work with CapCut. Check out my other videos with all the great features available. See you soon.